Welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we are simplifying ratios. Let's start with a skill I need you super good at for this video. Previously on Hegarty Maths, you've learned how to simplify fractions. Pause the video, double check you can do that. So I would have expected you to be able to get 3/4 there, and simplifying ratios is going to be very similar to simplifying fractions, so I need you familiar with what I've just done there. Next thing I need you super good at is understanding ratios. So I'd like you to pause the video and answer the following question. So it says, for every 3 girls in Mr. Hegarty's class, there are 4 boys. What's the ratio of girls to boys? I always like to draw a picture, so I'm going to do that now. The ratio is therefore 3 to 4. Now at this point, I want us to just stop a second, and I want us to think about ratios a little bit more deeply. So I'm going to move this 3 to 4 over here, if you don't mind. And what did 3 to 4 mean again? It meant every time I add 3 girls to the class, I must add 4 boys, or vice versa. If I add 4 boys to the class, I must add 3 girls. So let's do just that. Say I was to add another set of 3 girls to the class, I must add 4 boys. That will preserve the ratio, and it means I've got a new equivalent ratio to this, which would be 6 to 8. If I did the same thing again, what would I get? Well, I would get the new ratio 9 to 12. Okay, now another way you could think of this, if you think, how did I get from this first ratio to the second? You can think, well, I doubled the 3 and I doubled the 4. How did I get from the original ratio 3 to 4 to 9 to 12? Well, you could think of it as I multiplied the 3 by 3 and I multiplied the 4 by 3 as well. Without drawing the picture, what would the next ratio in this pattern be? Hopefully you realise it would be 12 to 16. And you could think of that as taking this 3 here, multiplying it by 4, and multiplying the 4 also by 4. And just to check the picture works, adding another 3 girls and another 4 boys would indeed get me 12 to 16. Now, it just so happens that 6 to 8, 9 to 12, and 12 to 16 are what's called equivalent ratios to 3 to 4. So, they are what we call equivalent. Now, 3 to 4 has a very special name too. The original ratio, the most simplest ratio, is called the ratio in simplest form. It is the ratio from which all the other equivalent ratios come from. A little bit like a fraction in simplest form and all the other equivalent fractions that come from it. So they're key ideas you need to know. And in general, how would you describe simplest form? Well, a ratio in simplest form has 2 integers as the 2 parts of it. And both those integers, the biggest number that divides into them is 1. Or another way of saying that is their highest common factor is 1. So let's reiterate that point. A ratio A to B is said to be in simplest form if A and B are integers, remember that just means whole numbers, and they have highest common factor 1. So now we know what a ratio being in simplest form means, let's go ahead and identify which of the following 8 are in simplest form. Pause the video, have a go. Well, 9 and 13 are integers, and their highest common factor is 1, so that certainly is in simplest form. 12 to 9, well, they are integers as well, however, the highest common factor of 12 and 9 is actually 3, isn't it? The highest common factor of these, 12 and 9, is 3. So you can divide both of these by 3. So in its current state, that is not in simplest form. 15 and 20 are integers, but you could divide them both by 5, so again, that's not in simplest form. This isn't in simplest form because 0.8 is not an integer, it's a decimal number. 1 to 15, well, they're both integers and their highest common factor is 1, so that's certainly a simplest form, as is 7 to 3 for the very same reason. But the last two are not in simplest form, well, because these ones are decimals and this third here is in fraction form, so they are not in simplest form. Having identified what simplest form is, let's now convert some ratios into their simplest form. Pause the video and have a go at this if you think you can. So we want to convert these all to simplest form. Step one is always to work out the highest common factor of the two numbers. So the highest common factor of 9 and 6 is 3. We could divide this by 3 to get 3. We could divide this side by 3 to get 2. and it's in simplest form. Next one, the highest common factor of 25 and 15, well, that's 5, isn't it? 5 divides into both. Divide this side by 5, you get 5. Divide this side by 5, you get 3. You've got your simplest form. The highest common factor of 60 and 42, well, that's 6. So you can divide this side by 6 and you get 10. You can divide this side by 6, you get 7. You've got yourself your simplest form. And the highest common factor of 12, 10 and 8 is 2. Divide each of them by 2, you get 6 to 5 to 4, and we're done. Next one, slightly harder. See if you can work out how to express these in simplest form. Well, what's not in simplest form about these is that they're fractions or decimal numbers. How could you easily get rid of this 1.5 here? What could you multiply both sides of the ratio to make, in particular, the right-hand side a nice whole number? Well, you could double it, right? If you doubled this side and you doubled this side, you would get the ratio 2 to 3. And they are in simplest form. 2 and 3 are integers. Their highest common factor is 1. You're done. The same works in the second case. You can double 2.5 to get 5. You can double 1.5 to get 3. You've got yourself your simplest form. The doubling trick works in part 3 as well. You double this side to get 12. You double this side to get 7. Happy days. Now the last one is not quite so easy, so if you don't mind, I'm going to go over here and do this one over here like this. Now, you've got two issues here. You're dividing by 2 here and you're dividing by 3 here. So you might say, let's get rid of that half or that division by 2. Let's multiply both sides by 2. Or you can think of it as multiplying by 2 over 1. On the left-hand side, that's going to give you 1, which is great. But on this side, you're going to get yourself 2 times 2, which is 4, over 1 times 3, which is 3. So you're not yet in simplest form, are you? Because you've still got a fraction on the right-hand side. What could you do? Well, now you could multiply by 3, couldn't you, to try and undo that divide by 3. Or you could think of it as multiplying by 3 over 1. That gets you on the left-hand side 3, and it gets you on the right-hand side 4, and you have simplified that ratio, and the ratio becomes 3 to 4, and you're done. You could have spotted straight away that multiplying both of these by 6 would have done the trick for you. Multiplying by 2 and then multiplying by 3 is the same as in one move multiplying by 6. Okay, next question. Pause the video, have a go. So we've got Colin and Brian are marking exam papers. Colin takes 40 minutes and Brian takes 1 hour. Express the times Colin and Brian takes as a ratio in its simplest form. So, Colin takes 40 minutes, Brian takes 1 hour. Remember, be super careful, they're in different units, so you must convert that 1 hour into minutes, so they're both minutes. That's probably the easiest way. So, Colin takes 40 minutes, Brian takes 1 hour, which is 60 minutes. Now, it did say give your answer in simplest form. You must simplify this and think to yourself, what's the highest common factor of 40 and 60? Well, if you're struggling with that, the highest common factor of 4 and 6 is 2, so the highest common factor of 40 and 60 must be 20. Divide this side by 20, 2 20s go into 40. Divide this side by 20, you get 3. There you go, your answer in simplest form. Next one, pause the video, have a go. For every £1 a company spends advertising, it also spends 48 pence on its website. Write down the ratio of website, be careful how you read it, to advertising expenditure. So, website, 48 pennies. Advertising, £1. Now, £1 is 100 good pennies, so we can write that as 48 to 100 like that. Now, clearly, you must simplify your ratio here. So, you've got to go away and think to yourself, what's the highest common factor of 48 and 100? Now, I know 4 goes into both of these, so I can divide this side by 4 and get 12. I can divide this side by 4 and I can get 25. Have a think to myself, is that in simplest form? It is, because I can't think of any other number other than 1 that divides into 12 and 25. So we're done. Right, last one. Pause the video, have a go. So it says, consider the following two triangles, state the ratio of smaller red to the larger red, smaller blue to the larger blue, smaller green to the larger green. So, the smaller Triangle here is 3, this one here is 4, so it's 3 to 4. We can't simplify that. What about in the blue case? Well, it's 6 to 8, isn't it? 6 to 8. But we could simplify that. We could divide both sides by 2, and it would become 3 to 4 as our final answer. And what about the last case? Well, it would be 9 to 12. And again, we could simplify that. We could divide both sides by 3, and again, we'd get 3 to 4. Okay, and this here is our little introduction to something we're going to see later in geometry. The ratio of the small sides in the small triangle to the big sides in the big triangle is actually always 3 to 4. And that ratio is constant between all the sides, and there's a special name for this. These are called similar triangles. Okay, so similar triangles are ones where there is a preserved ratio between the sides of the two triangles. That's it for this particular video. Thank you very much for watching.